Yes, like I told you once, I was at Unicom when Austin scored his first goal for Rangers against ACB. And it was a very tight game. And then he comes on. How did you feel? Seriously, there you were playing for Rangers at the time, and your younger brother was coming on.
Well, I think if whenever I think about JJ, about Austin, there's always this wry smile on my face, you know, because knowing how we grew up and everything. When I was in the national team, that was late 89 and early 1990. He was playing for the school team, you know, and I never took time to actually find out how he was doing playing. You know, we went to the same school, but he was that junior. I left when he was still in class one or two. So I've never actually took notice of how, maybe because I was so much engrossed with my own career, you know, I was always traveling, and I never actually found out how good he was, or, you know, or what's going on his side. But when I came back, he had now signed for CCB, that's a bank, and he was playing for them. And I was like, okay, I'm gonna go see how he's doing one of these days. But eventually, the next game we had then, FA Cup game, was against CCB. So I didn't even know he was in the first team. I used to hear little things about him, but I never knew he was in the first team. So when we lined up, I saw him lining up on the other side. I was like, listen, have you finished your house chores? Did you finish washing the plates before you came out? He was laughing, you know. And then we shook hands, and when the game started, to my utmost surprise, he was man of the match. He tore Rangers apart. We won that game 1-0, but it was narrowly, you know. And I was like, okay, that gave me a little bit of something to think about. He in a very short way, he brought tears to my eyes a lot of times watching him play. And that tells you something.
I'm really proud of him as a brother.
Nice. Very, very.